Let's grab our superpowers and take our shapes from Canva and create this cool, amazing logo using shapes from Canva. After opening up your blank canvas, you're going to change color and make it black. Then add a circle and change the color of your circle and make it green. Duplicate the shape so that you have two extra circles. The one is going to be a green circle, the other one you're going to change it and make the color black. Size and align your black circle above the green circle. What we're doing here is to create a tree shaped like using these circles. Group the two shapes and align them so that you have the left hand side of your tree. Copy the black circle over the other second green circle of ours to create exactly the same shape for the right hand side of our tree. Align the two shapes next to each other to create a tree shaped like design. Duplicate your shapes and the second step, make it a little bit smaller. And the third step, again, make that a little bit smaller to create your tree. Let's make a little bit of an adjustment here. Select your black circle and then reduce the black circle, or rather increase the green, so that the tree looks like a tree. So do that on all three shapes and you've created your pine tree this way. Great stuff. After you're done, you're gonna highlight all of your shapes and you're gonna group them and put them on the side and go back to your lines and shapes. Add a triangle because we want to add the top of our pine tree. In order for the design of the tree to look authentic, we're gonna add another circle. We're going to reduce it and squeeze it and rotate it, change the color and make it black, and then align it on the rectangle to create the top of a pine tree. Gotta get through this, life is a nuisance, life's a nuisance. I try to be human, find a solution, my evolution. A place like this, it didn't exist, you made it like this. So you can go pick the bad or the good, got a glass half wish, I know. It's easier to hide and just to lay low. Not everyone in life has got a halo. I'm standing in the red inside a pale. Then head over to your lines and shapes and grab the pearl shape and add it in the middle of your tree to close those gaps that we see over there. Looking at my pine tree, I'm not happy with the way that it looks, so I'm going to ungroup it. Make a little bit of an adjustment using my black circles and adjust it so that it looks like a tree. Once you're done, then you can go right ahead, reduce the size and put it on this side. Next, we're going to add a circle again. We're creating a nice sun. This is fairly quick and easy. You're going to add your big circle, change color and make it a nice gradient-y reddish, like a sun color. And then add another circle and change the color of that one and make it black. Align it on top of our sun. And we have a gorgeous sun. Next, we're going to duplicate our tree so that we have three trees. One in the middle is going to be larger than the two, and we'll have two small trees next to each other. Next, we're going to go back to our lines and shapes, scroll down until we find the cloud shape. Then we're going to edit on our design and we're going to squeeze it and make the shape smaller. We are creating a ground-like look with grass, and we're going to squeeze it and I'm going to align it below our trees. Our next stop is to add the tree stumps. We're going to go back to our lines and shapes, so you can press R for rectangle and create a square shape and then size it to create the tree stumps for the three trees. Science, please, you're all too loud. You don't speak quietly. Opinions violently thrown across every surface. It makes me nervous. It's the world honestly burning. Our last step on the design is to press T and add the name of the company. We're going to press T for text, and the font that I'm going to be using for this one, because it's a nice and roundish, it's very similar to Sans fonts. We're going to be using a Hammersmith 1 font. Your 2D logo is done and created. If you were to stop here and you're happy with the background of being black, your 2D is done. If you want to convert it to a 3D, all of the circles that we've changed and made black and our background, we need to change back to white so that we are able to remove the whites using our remove.bg. So I went ahead and changed everything to white, and then we're going to go share and click on transparent background and click on download. Then we're going to log into www.erase.bg or www.remove.bg to take off the white circles that we've created. Canva used to do this for us, but with the update, they don't. So we're going to use remove.bg. You're going to add your 2D logo on there, and it will remove the background as well as the shapes. You're going to click on download, and your design is downloaded. You're then going to log in on photopea.com, and you're going to select the templates in order for you to change it to a 3D. Okay, great stuff. Once you've selected PSD templates, you can pick any mockup you want. I love this elegant logo mockup. You click on the link where it says photo p jibba jabba, and it will load the mockup on your design. Once it has loaded, go double click where it says your logo here on the checkered box and click on the eye to hide the designer's example. Then click and drag your 2D logo that you've just downloaded from remove.bg. Size it and align it, make it the size that the designer has showed you. So if you want it to be nice and big and visible, make it nice and big. Once that's done, you need to convert your design to a smart object. So you're going to press Ctrl S or Command S on your keyboard. You could also go File and click on Save as Smart Object. Once that's done, you're going to click on the first tab to go access your 3D logo that you've designed. You could always now export this as a PNG or a JPEG or a PDF. It depends what kind of file you want to export this as. If you enjoy these shapes logos, we have a playlist that's created just for shapes logos. Go access it here. Otherwise, thank you so much for joining me today. I will see you on the next video.